Hello friends, this is Abhinav Bhargav and in this video we are going to see about NAM, that is non-aligned movement, and it is not an organization but just a movement. Let us see some background history. That is, after Second World War, the world was divided into bipolar. That is the rise of two new superpowers and emergence of Western and the Eastern countries. The Western countries was mostly led by USA and it is called as First World countries and they adopted capitalism. Whereas on the other hand, the Eastern countries led by USSR and they are called as Second World countries and mostly led by communist form. And the proxy war between these two countries is nothing but the Cold War, that is no peace, no war. Then after that, we have this emergence of Third World countries, mostly led by Afro-Asian and Latin American countries. And they are just born and not willing to join either First World or the Second World countries. And the four heroes, also called as NAM heroes, that is Nehru, Nasser, Sukarno and Marshall Tito, they initiated this movement, that is NAM. And the factual information what you can remember is that the Marshall Tito, he came to the Third World from the Second World and the NAM name was given by Nehru. So what Nehru said is that NAM is just an independent bloc with freedom of decision making by countries and freedom to take action, and it is for national identity. That is, NAM don't want to have rivalry with other countries since these are newly born countries. And the objectives of NAM include independence of blocs, global peace, decolonization, that is NAM will support all freedom struggle countries, and it is against apartheid and racial discrimination. So everything is fine. Now let us see how it all started. That is, in the year 1955, there was a conference at Bandung, that is in Indonesia, and 29 Afro-Asian countries assembled and the birth or beginning of NAM started. However, the leaders were four countries and it was on the basis of Panchil principle. NAM was officially born in the year 1961 at Belgrade, which is in Yugoslavia, and the first session took place at Belgrade, started with 25 members, and every 3 years we have this NAM conference, and till now we had 16 NAM summits. In the 2012 we have the 16 NAM summit at Tehran, and in the year 2016 we are going to have 17 NAM summit at Venezuela. And today NAM is the second largest global organization next to UNO with almost 55% of global population. So what is the relevance of NAM in this changed environment? See, collapse of USSR leads to bipolar world move to a unipolar world and the end of Cold War. And the objectives were outdated and hence a new orientation must be required. Here we can see that the tension between East and West came to an end and the economic disparity between North and South is increasing. And NAM should focus on development of southern countries. So what could be the new objectives of NAM? That is promoting North-South cooperation and South-South cooperation. That is North-South and South-South cooperation. And it should focus on terrorism. That is, member countries should work together to end terrorism. And NAM shall become the supportive representative of developing countries in UNO and others. And it should focus on environment and ecology. And NAM shall work for multipolar world by creating or supporting SAR or ASEAN countries. Here we can say that the relevance of NAM today is even more than it was in the 1960s. So this is the basic overview of NAM. Do subscribe to this channel and thank you.